Had ik net een staal wil doen. Fuck you, Bradley.
Building.
You see, there's a lot of construction going on in this area that is part of the Better Miami movement. So a lot of these are Deco style buildings are under reconstruction, but once again, mainly on the inside. This is a new condo building. Hotels and condominiums. Now this part of the beach is called Mid Beach. We're no longer in South Beach. This is Mid Beach, the residential area. So you'll see a lot of apartments and condos and quite a few hotels in this area, but mainly residential. South Beach is known for their nightclubs, restaurants, Art Deco styles, parties, etc. Over here to your right is going to be another Art Deco style building called the Cadillac. Back in the days, this used to be one of Elvis Presley's favorite places to stay. The Art Deco Cadillac Hotel. To the right, the Thompson and the Crown, all one hotel. At the very top of the Crown is an outside spa. And the building you see directly in front of us, that is the Fountain Blue condominiums. The original Fountain Blue is a hotel that was built in the 1930s. These condos were built in 2007. Once again, Fountain Blue condominiums directly in front. Let's get around. We're going to turn around here to the right-hand side. You see that fountain on side of the road, side of the building right there. It says the Fountain Blue. That name is for the condominiums. The hotel was so popular back in the 50s and 60s that it did not need a name on the front of that hotel. Everyone knew about it. So still today, you will not see a name on the front of that hotel. This name that you see, the Fountain Blue, is for those condominiums. Over here to the right hand side, you're going to see the original Fountain Blue Hotel built in 1954. Some of the celebrities that stayed here was Elvis Presley, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, Marilyn Monroe, etc. You saw the movie My Bodyguard with Whitney Houston and Kevin Costner. It was filmed here at the Fountain Blue Hotel, as well as James Bond. This is stop number 8, everyone. Stop number 8, Fountain Blue Hotel. Once again, if you saw James Bond with Sean Connery, it was also filmed too. Everyone, this is... I have to take a picture with that guy. Looks like Obama, doesn't it? A little bit. Hi guys, we're living. Oh, and as we continue to make our way here on this tour.
Obama.
Again, you never know what you'll see on the beach.
Yes, you do.
We're going to make this right here on 10th Street as we continue to make our way. That building directly in front of us to the right. Once we make this right, it's going to be on your left. There's the Wilferson campus that belongs to the Miami-Dade Community College. Now, Mrs. Wilferson is one of the women that brought the Art Deco style here to Miami, Miami Beach. So once again, on both sides of the bus, that is an Art Deco style building. You can see it's under reconstruction, but mainly from the inside. The outside, they could not touch the art design of Art Deco because it is a preserved art. Directly in the front of us, that is the SS House, built in the 1930s. On the other side, those are apartments called the Edwards Apartments, originally built in 1934. And to the right-hand side of us is another Art Deco style building. Once again, as you can see, some of these buildings have different shapes, like the SS House over here to the left has the shape of a rocket at the very top. Some of them are shaped like cruise ships. We're going to see that as we continue on throughout the tour. To the left-hand side, that is called the Clevelander. The Clevelander Hotel. There is where you'll find the ESPN Studios. Very, very popular place at nighttime. This is the place to be at nighttime. The Clevelander, a lot of outside dancing, dances on the sidewalks, etc. The Art Deco Welcoming Center in front of you. Now, the Clevelander is a drunk-proof hotel because all the furniture is bolted to the floor. And all the floors in every room is a dream. So again, you'll see, as we get here, all the three stories. These are some of the original Art Deco style buildings. They were originally built here on South Beach. A lot of the three-story ones here as we make our way. All the Art Deco style building. Now there's one that is a Mediterranean mixed with an Italian style design. That is the only one here that separates itself from Art Deco. That is a building coming to your left. That is the Gianni Versace Mansion. This is where Versace was shot and killed in 1997, right here in front of his mansion here to the left, in 1997. That mansion recently sold for $41.5 million to a gentleman named Joe Nakash, the owner of this hotel right next door, Hotel Victor. He is also one of the creators of Jordache Jeans. The second highest bidder was Donald Trump, who stopped bidding at $40 million. Now, the swimming pool on the inside of the Versace Mansion is layered in 24 karat gold. Yes, lots of money. So Once again, as we continue here on, pay attention to all the three stolen buildings, all Art Deco, original Art Deco in Miami Beach. Now over here to the left, that purple awning, that is called the Carlisle Hotel, where they filmed the movie Birdcage with Robin Williams. But over here, you'll see this building, it is called the Cardoza. When the singer Gloria Estefan came from Cuba as a little girl, she took a picture in front of this building. She now owns it. Yes. And again, remember, these are still all Art Deco style buildings. Now, again, once in mind, keep in mind, when they started building them a little taller, it was later on. But the original ones built in the 1930s and 40s were built three stories. And again, the reason they were built three stories is so that the air can flow through the houses a lot easier. Because these were built without air conditioning at that time. So the three stories and three windows were, again, for you to get a breeze to come through your window and go and flow throughout the entire of the home. And they're also known for their three colors. All the colors are pastel colors, like this one, for example, to the left. Three stories, three colors, and three windows. Now, directly ahead, these became a little bit more modern than the three stories. Those big ones that you see in front of us, those are all Art Deco style buildings. Now, that is part of an Art Deco Mecca design. It's Art Deco Mecca design to look like there's a lot going on in one particular area. Now, a lot of those are shaped like cruise ships as well as spaceships. So again, they have the little curvy edges, the little slanted tops, and the little side entrance on the different sides of the buildings. So as we make a left, we're going to see one. This one here that you see to your left, that is actually a cruise ship Art Deco design. Once again, the one that we're passing here, we're going to be seeing that a little bit more.
Miami,
but that
turns
has a cruise ship Art Deco
art
design. And you're going to see more of that cruise ship when we make this left.
Tim's absolute proof. So,
once again, this road we're traveling on is called Ocean Drive. We're going to make a left here on 15th. Go down to that next traffic light and make a right as we continue on. Now, directly in front of us, that was called the Aladdin Hotel. That was under renovation right now. Again, another original Art Deco style building. That looks like the back of an old cruise ship. The one over here to the left, that is the one that is built like a cruise ship, Art Deco.
Him on his belly, right there it goes, he got it. Can't let that bite go to waste.
Right here, and we're going to be coming up to stop number five, a little further up. So again, stop number five, the Rose Hotel. That big building right there, that is an Art Deco style building to the right, shaped like a spaceship or a rocket. Art Deco built in 1996, the first grand hotel to open in Miami Beach in the last 30 years. The restaurant on the inside of this hotel is owned by the famed chef who loves to kick it up a notch, Emeril Lagasse. Once again, everyone, this is stop number five, the Lowe's Hotel. Watch your step, everyone, on the way down. Be careful.
Thank you.
once again, welcome aboard. This is Big Bus. I'm Clyde, your tour guide. Your driver downstairs is Bradley. This is the blue line throughout Miami Beach. This road that we're coming up to is called Lincoln Road. Once again, Lincoln Road. We're going to continue to make our way here on Collins Avenue. Take Collins Avenue all the way up to 50th Street. Over here to the right, that is the National Hotel. When that hotel was built in the 1930s, it was the most popular hotel in Miami Beach. Could have had a swimming pool 250 feet long. Right next door to it, this is the Delano, named after the president, Franklin D. Roosevelt. Also has a nightclub on the inside. It's called the FDR. This hotel was once owned by the singer Madonna. These buildings are also all Art Deco style buildings, like the one right next to it, the SLS. When that hotel opened in 1939, it was the first hotel built on Miami Beach with an air conditioning. So again, this is all still an Art Deco style district as we make our way here. And again, that continued design also consists here on the left-hand side. A lot of these buildings are still under reconstruction, mainly from the inside. Watch your head, guys, to the right. Be careful. Watch your heads. Watch your heads, everyone. Watch your heads. Now coming up over here to the right, another Art Deco-style building built in 1937, the Raleigh. The lobby of that hotel was designed by Ralph Lauren. Now you'll see those little lips over the windows right there. Those were called eyebrows back in the days. Eyebrows. Again, on the Art Deco style building, the eyebrows were actually there to defend the sun so that they did not produce that much sunlight into the home and prevent your room from heating up. Because again, they did not have air conditioning. To the right, that is another Art Deco that is called the Satai Hotel and Steakhouse, owned by the fighter Jack Dempsey. Again, originally owned by the fighter Jack Dempsey. Now on the left-hand side, that is Collins Park. Art Museum of Miami Beach, the Museum of Bass, Bass Museum of Art, one of the major locations of Art Basel. This is stop number 6, everyone, stop number 6, 22 Street, as well as Collins Avenue. To the right, that is the W Hotel. Every one of those rooms gets a view of the beach. That is because of the way those balconies are slanted. Down at the very bottom, there's a very popular restaurant called Mr. Chow that is founded and owned by a personal and famous chef, Michael Chow. The original Michael Chow restaurant is in New York City. Michael Chow is also the personal chef of the singer Beyonce and her husband Jay-Z. Thank you. That is called the Red Palms Hotel and Spa Marine Hotel. The restaurant only serves organic food and the spa only uses natural creams. We're coming up to stop number 7, everyone. Stop number 7, Nehru Hotel.